So today's event is the Expanding Your Horizons event, STEM Career Day for Young Women here at Penn State. It's actually, Expanding Your Horizons is part of a national network, so there are schools all across the country that have these events that focus on exposing young women to STEM careers and STEM studies. So this is just our version of it, and we've had it for 7 years, and it grows every year. So it's a great great way to get the energy up about women in STEM, and it's one of our favorite ones of the year. Science U camps are one of our other big programs that runs all summer, but this is our one event of the year that really focuses on just the women and the girls in STEM. And so it's kind of complement in that point, and the fact that it, you know, is during the school year when they're making decisions about what classes to take and what to do next summer, or, you know, what to do next year, I think it's a critical juncture, and I think that's why it's really important. Each group of girls went to a unique set of workshops. What they have in common is that they were run by real practitioners in STEM, majority of whom are women for today, you know, to help guide them, the people who want to share their passion with the girls and try to get them interested or at least exposed to what's possible for them in STEM. So I think that aspect of it is the common theme throughout all the workshops.
Our workshop is entitled Disease Detectives, Using Statistics to Solve Health Mysteries. And so it's really just an applied workshop showing people how we use statistics in public health to determine whether there are outbreaks, what the source of the outbreak is, deciding what risk factors we should be targeting. So really just an example of how math concepts that you learn early on really do come into play later in life. I think the value of having women in science is just giving young women role models and a face to look to. I think just like anything else, if you don't see women doing it, it's not very clear that it's an option to you. And so I just like girls of all different types and interests to see women who it looks like they represent them, because I think that that makes it seem like more of a possibility that they can achieve the same thing.
Very strongly about increasing girls' and women's interest in mathematics, and oftentimes when I see them as undergraduates, it's already too late. They already decided they're not good at math or they don't like math, and I feel very passionate about teaching them at this early age when they're still very open and excited about things. I also have two young daughters who I also hope will not just be turned off by math, but will find math interesting. Yeah.
Part of the importance of it is that I think scientific and technological developments are becoming more and more important to how our society operates. So I feel personally, the more people who are comfortable with science, don't think it's some scary, kind of unreachable, unapproachable thing, is important just for society in general. So when I see 160 girls spend a Saturday, when they could be doing so many other things, you know, learning more about STEM careers and what they could do with science in their futures, that's what gets me excited about it. So then I feel like a lot of our presenters and volunteers probably feel the same way.